Hi, I'm Jennifer, I'm the creative blogger and digital artist for Life is Messy and Brilliant. Life is Messy and Brilliant is a blog about colorful printables, hand lettering worksheets, and digital planning. On today's video, I'm going to explain what is a digital planner and how to use it. You can also find a blog post explaining this in my blog. I'll make sure to leave a link in the description box. All right, let's get started. So in my shop, I have a couple of digital planners. What's different about my planners from the ones you find in Etsy is that these planners are editable or customizable. For example, this one, you can change the pink cover to any color or image. You can change all the links. You can change the names on the tabs and also the names on all the spreads. And the planner comes with a couple of extra spreads that you can customize and edit and change to your liking, which is something I always look forward to when I want to play with a planner. I want to make it my own. I want to put my own touch into it. So that's my goal behind all my digital planners. And it also comes with instructions. So I have this one that is a dated version for Apple, and then this one that is for PowerPoint. So it's for my users that have a Windows or Android phone or a tablet. I will make sure to leave a discount code in the description box, and that way you can check it out and see a couple other stuff that I offer. All right, so if you download any of my planners, you will get a download link. If you're using Google Chrome, you will click on the download now and it will appear at the bottom and select download. If you're using Safari, you will click download now, which will show up a pop-up. Click download and then it will appear in the top right of your iPad. All right, once the planner finishes downloading in Google Chrome, you will get this little pop-up. You will select open in and then save it to files. I usually save mine in the download section. If you are in Safari, you will just click on the planner you just downloaded. It will appear also in the download section of the files app. Click on it to reveal its content. Now, this planner comes with two versions, a PDF and a Keynote version. The PDF version is for you to be able to edit the planner in the GoodNotes app. So you're going to click on PDF, and I have the whole planner. Depending on which planner you choose, this one is the dated one, which starts in January and ends in December. And I also broke it down in two sections or 6 months, January to June and July to December. That way it's a little bit less heavy on your app, or it takes less storage is what I'm trying to say. So let's say if you're gonna choose this one, it will open like this. Click on the arrow that's pointing upwards and select GoodNotes or Notability or Note Selves. I believe those are the most popular apps to use for digital planning. A digital planner is a bullet journal inside your iPad. You have the options to click on the hyperlinks, which is what people love the most about digital planners. You can click on any of the links and it will take you to a specific page on the planner. So I want to jump into an April. Let's go to the weekly spread of April. That's the beauty of digital planning. Also, with the Apple Pencil, you can draw on the pages. If you're taking notes in college, I highly suggest turning on this option, which brings a little box. Not a little, actually, but it brings a box that will allow you to keep writing. For example, yes. You can also use the highlighter. So let's say I want this width, but that's too small, so you can change the width of the you can change the width of the highlighter and also the pen. So I'm going to flip this, choose a bigger width, and then you can draw like, oops, I'm so sorry. You can draw like this, which is a little crooked, or you can turn on the draw straight line, keep your finger on the screen or the pencil on the screen, and it will draw a straight line. You can also add images to the planner. Say I have this beautiful sticker here and I want to put it on the wick. Right there. And then you can also write on top of the image. I usually prefer white. And you can also use stickers, which come already in the GoodNotes app. And then one of the best features that you will not get with a regular bullet journal is the ability to move things. For example, if you select the lasso tool, you can move the handwriting along with the text. Or if you decided, you know what, I only meant to move the image and not the handwriting. There we go. Those are one of the cool things about digital planning, is the ability to use a little bit more of the technology to play around with the planner. You can also add a text box. And you can use fonts. So I have a couple of fonts installed on my iPad, which is the best thing about digital planning. Sometimes your handwriting might not be the best. I know mine can be funny. So a beautiful way to write titles is by choosing different fonts and playing around with them. Now I want to show you a different planner, or a different digital planner, which is in Keynote. Keynote is the PowerPoint version of Apple. Here you can change the cover on the planner, so like select all. We're going to select the paintbrush icon, background, select a different color, or what I prefer to do is select an image. I save all my images in OneDrive and I download them offline, that way they can load faster and I can access them anytime. So as you can see, the border on all the pages of planner change, and the cool thing is that you can have each month with a different background. So for example, let's say January has this, but you change your mind, you decided you want different. So we're going to select all the slides in January. And select a different background. Here we go. As you can see, all the background of January is different, but we can keep the main planner with a different background, and then each separate month you can have it personalized. I hope that makes sense. Now, on the Keynote app, we can do the same thing as GoodNotes. We can add images. We can draw on the pages, and we can even add the tables of content. So let me show you a little bit of what I can do with Keynote. I want to change this next week to something else. I'm going to select fine. I'm going to type next week. And here, new text. Select replace. And as you can see, the more you click replace, it starts changing it on all the other slides. I'm going to click done and go back to the other ones. Here is the new one, new text. In Keynote, it's very simple to change the text in all the slides. Something that you can do in GoodNotes. And you can do the same thing for the tabs or any other text that is on the Keynote app. Now, let's say this spread looks pretty, but it's not really what you're looking for. You can just keep your finger press on the screen, select the whole thing and delete it. And open the editable spreads that come with the planner. Let me choose a new one. Let's say maybe a new pretty one. This is one of the new ones that I added to the collection. You're going to select somewhere in the screen, select all objects, select all, done, click copy, and now we're going back and paste. There we go. That's another easy, simple and easy way to switch the spreads that come with the planner. I prefer to offer several different spreads. That way you have the option to customize it, change it. You can also change the images that come in the washi tape or the stickers. The idea behind all my Keynote planners is for you to have the freedom to edit everything, just like you will in a bullet journal. I want you to be able to change the font, to change the color, to change the images, to create the perfect planner that is just for you. Let me know in the comment section if you have any questions and if you like to see other videos comparing the two apps or things that you might still a little bit doubtous about. Don't forget to stop by my blog. I often post about bullet journaling, digital planning, and I offer a couple of free printables. They're usually very beautiful and chic. And let me know what other videos you would like to see in the future. Have a great day.